Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. Happy Saturday. It is Saturday, so you know what that means. It's grocery haul day. It's not just grocery haul day. It is massive grocery haul day. I hit up several stores. I did my Costco shopping, which always adds a lot of items to the grocery haul. I did Walmart grocery pickup, Fred Meyer, which is a local Kroger store, Trader Joe's, and Natural Grocers, which is our version of Sprouts or Whole Foods. So holy moly, I had to do this grocery haul in two separate sets because my island was full. I couldn't put another item on there, so you're gonna get a huge, huge grocery haul in two separate sections today. I have a lot of new fun food finds, and of course, just stocking up on all my favorite things, and then I share my meal plan and meal prep with you guys as well. So without further ado, because this is a massive grocery haul, let's jump in. When I said massive, I meant massive. You guys, this is part one of my haul. I have a whole nother section of this huge, massive stock up haul. Again, I went to several stores. I did Costco, Walmart grocery pickup, Fred Meyer, which is a Kroger store, Trader Joe's, and Natural Grocers, which is like a Sprouts or Whole Foods, what we have in my area. So holy moly, we have some groceries, so we better get started. At Costco, I picked up two of the acid reducers. These are currently on coupon through the 16th of July for $10, which is such a great deal. You get about a month's supply for $15 at the pharmacy. So I went ahead and grabbed two because they don't go bad, and both me and my husband take one pretty much every single day. I also grabbed some more plastic food wrap because the stuff I buy at the store, the Glad one, I hate it. This one is so much better. Both of these are about $10, which is such a fantastic deal. You can see tucked back here is a big pack of Charmin. So they had toilet paper, so I grabbed it. Also, my husband loves these pepperoni pizzas. These are the Kirkland frozen thin crust pizzas. He absolutely loves these. I just take them out of the box, throw them in my freezer. He eats one or at least half of one for a meal, and it just makes it really easy, especially if he's not interested in eating what I made for the night or he doesn't like it, then this is a great alternative for him, or when he's home alone and just has to quickly cook up a dinner. And speaking of pizza, I grabbed some turkey Hormel pepperoni just because I need that for a couple of recipes. And also, I grabbed a loaf of the Private Selection, just sourdough wide pan bread. This is for my husband's lunches. He's gonna be doing like a turkey pastrami and Swiss sandwich this next week, so I grabbed him some bread. At Trader Joe's, I picked up the Light Laughing Cow just because I was completely out, and I like to have these on hand just to spread on wraps or use as a condiment in place of mayonnaise or cheese. It really helps save on points, and these are only 1.30 calories. As you know, this is the salad at Costco that my husband is obsessed with. I do not like this at all. Let me know in the comments if you guys have tried this and if you like it. For some reason, I'm just not a fan. It has tortellini and sausage and olives and mozzarella. He loves it, and it's seasonal, so I always try to pick it up for him whenever I go to Costco, so that is for him. And then for a recipe, I picked up this pizza dough at Trader Joe's just because there was a way to make it myself, but you know what? This just makes it a lot easier. I think this is for my meal prep dessert, so stay tuned on Monday for that. I grabbed some more of the Ezekiel Pita Pockets. You guys know that I really, really like these. These are only 100 calories. They make a great substitution for avocado toast or, of course, for any type of pita or sandwich, so I grabbed those. Also, at Trader Joe's, I've heard nothing but good things about these. These are the cauliflower thins, the versatile bread substitute. So I've heard that these are really good. They don't taste like cauliflower. You wouldn't even know that it is cauliflower. So you can have two pieces for 100 calories. Here are your ingredients, which actually they have pretty darn good ingredients. So I grabbed it and I thought, let's give them a try and see what we think. Again, great sub for avocado toast. I picked up some Applegate smoked turkey because I do like to sometimes just make a turkey sandwich. And again, I can put that here on the pitas, or I can even put the turkey on the cauliflower thins, but that would be a great sandwich. Some dark red kidney beans. This is for a recipe. I also needed some cheddar soup. Now, this does not have the best ingredients, but there wasn't a way for me to work around that. I have not seen a clean cheddar soup. So if you have, please let me know down in the comments. And then I needed to restock my cinnamon. I'm literally about out of cinnamon. And this was a new thing at Trader Joe's. Now, I almost didn't get it because the barley is not organic, and you never want to have any type of grain like oats and barley and quinoa that isn't organic, just because it is heavily sprayed with pesticides. But it is Korean roasted barley tea, and I thought maybe they don't spray them as heavily in Korea as they do here, but I wanted to try this. It's a brand new item at Trader Joe's. It's 0 points. It has really like perfect ingredients. There's really nothing in here that's questionable at all, so I thought that this would be a nice little treat on a hot day. And then I went ahead and grabbed some more oven ready lasagna just because I need it for an upcoming recipe. I do have some left over from the last time that I bought it, but I don't think enough to complete the whole recipe. And also at Trader Joe's, as always, I restocked my cheeses. So I have one bag of the organic mozzarella. I mentioned this last week in my meal prep. If you guys are looking for a great dupe for that light cheese that Trader Joe's used to have, I don't know that it's coming back, guys. This is a great substitution. It is a quarter cup for 2 points, which is such a great deal. And then I also grabbed 2 bags of the light shredded just because we need it for several recipes this next week. The big, huge, ginormous bag of cut up olives from Costco. I've gotten a few questions on how I store these. What I do is I drain a lot of the liquid and then store them just in a Ziploc container in the refrigerator. My husband loves black olives, so he goes through these so fast, there's no way that they would go bad. And this entire bag at Costco is $5 and it's 2 pounds. So killer price. Also, while they have them, I can't pass up the patio chips from Trader Joe's. I love these. It's my guilty pleasure. It's the thing I like to eat that doesn't have the best ingredients. These are seasonal. They are incredible, you guys. It's a mix of salt and vinegar, dill, ketchup, and barbecue potato chips. Oh, it's to die for. I measure them out on my food scale. I have one serving. I track it and I move on, and they're delicious. And then I picked up my favorite hummus just because I have been unable to find this at a few stores. I love the kale pesto hope. This is the cleanest hummus you guys are going to find and the lowest point. You can actually have 3 tablespoons for 2 points instead of 2 tablespoons for 2 points. And I just love this kale pesto. It's so good. Now this mayonnaise, I went to Costco hoping for the Chosen Foods avocado because you guys know that's my favorite. They didn't have it. And we are almost out of mayo for my husband's sandwiches. So I'm going to hoard what's left of the Chosen Foods. And he said he's fine with just Best Foods. So I picked that up at Costco. A little disappointed. Some Jet Dry. This was on sale for $6, which is such a great deal. I find with my new dishwasher, this is a must. The dishes come out cloudy without this. And one little bit in the container lasts forever in the dishwasher. So I couldn't pass up $6 at Costco. And then you guys know my husband's love for the yogurt pretzels. I like these too, but they are really high in points. And again, not the best ingredients, but he asked for these for his lunches this next week. So if you have kids or a husband that likes these are really, really good. I also picked up some fat-free Catalina or French dressing. I actually wanted light and they didn't have it. No salad dressing, other than if you make it yourself or buy the, you know, Primal Kitchens of the world, have very good ingredients. But I needed this for a recipe and my husband likes French, so I know that he'll eat up the rest. So I picked that up. And then this was something that I've heard about, but I've never tried. This is the Rebel Maca Cold Brew Energizing Blend. So this is cold brew coffee, vanilla, and coconut milk. So I don't know the points. I'll put them here on the screen, but it's 110 calories. It has really, really good ingredients. And I thought that this might be just a treat. If I don't want to make coffee one morning, or maybe I need a little afternoon pick-me-up, this is portable. I can take it with me. So I'm excited to try that. And then I also, at the natural food store, grabbed some more of my favorite chips. These are the Siete. This is the Sali Limon. I've never tried this one, but I love the lime one, and this one just sounds really good. These chips are grain-free. They're made with avocado oil. They're the best. I love them, so I'm excited to have this flavor. Whenever I see them on sale, I grab them because they are a little bit pricey, but well worth it. And then I got these for my husband's lunch. There was actually a coupon at Kroger for buy one, get one free. So this is the Bear Raspberry Real Fruit Yo-Yo. So this is 100% fruit and veggie roll, one cup of fruit per little pack. So you guys remember fruit roll-ups as a kid. That's basically what this is. Oh, here we go. Here's your ingredients. So it actually has really, really good ingredients. So there are 60 calories. All that's in here is apples, pears, raspberries, and black carrot extract. So I knew that he would like these. I honestly would probably count these as 0 points, but I don't count dried fruit unless there's added sugar. So track it as you wish, but I got him the raspberry and the strawberry, and honestly, I probably won't eat these anyways. And then at Costco, I grabbed some vitamins. All of their vitamins and health items are on sale right now through the 16th. This was $8 for 2 packs. And then, as always, I grabbed the Entenmann's mini pies. My husband loves these for his lunch. So I actually grabbed him the cherry and the apple. So he'll be excited to have those. And you know what I just realized? Look at the expiration date. Come on, I just bought this today. It's the 15th. Ugh. So he'll definitely have to eat the cherry first. What's the expiration on this one? The 24th. So, yep. I'll let him know he needs to eat these up first. I mean, that's the sell-by date, but how frustrating. This came from Walmart pickup. Otherwise, I would not have bought one that expired tomorrow. So, darn it. And then over here, my stack of beverages. This is brand new at Trader Joe's. This is the sparkling black tea with peach juice. Now, you guys, this tea is 15 calories. I believe it's 0 points. I don't know. I'll put it on the screen. But look at these ingredients. Perfection. So, it is basically a sparkling tea with peach, and I heard that it's really, really good. I heard the peach is really strong and on point, so I can't wait. I picked up two. These are seasonal. They were $3.99 a 4-pack. And then, as always, my Zevia. This time I grabbed the ginger ale because they were out of the root beer. And down here behind these pies is my pack, if I can show you, of kombucha. There it is, the 6-pack of kombucha that I always buy at Walmart. The addiction is almost as real as with the Cleo bars with the Good Culture. So my natural food store, that's what I went there for mainly, was this Good Culture. And then I wanted to get some more Siete. These were, they had a big stock. So I grabbed them and they don't expire till August 10th. I eat these every day, sometimes twice a day. So I picked up 4 of the whole milk classic Good Culture cottage cheese. If you guys can find this in your area, get it. It is incredible. It is the best cottage cheese literally ever. I mean, it's so good. So I picked up 4 of those just to have on hand. And then back here is some Kleenex. We were almost out. Man, Costco was really picked over. They didn't have my mayonnaise. They didn't have the Kleenex I usually buy. They actually didn't have any paper towels. So it was interesting, but I needed Kleenex. So I thought these antiviral ones would be just fine. And everything else in this portion of the haul is produce. So I have some organic romaine lettuce. We are doing a Doritos salad. So stay tuned for that when I go over my meal plan. So we needed romaine for that. And then these were on a great price at Kroger. These are the organic blueberries. These were $4.99 for this whole pack, which is a pound, 1.2, 1 pound, 2 ounces. Whew, that's a mouthful. So I grabbed those. And then I was so excited that Trader Joe's had organic grapes, because grapes are on the dirty dozen. So you want to make sure you're picking those up organic. Great price for these, less than $6. And then $6.99 for a big pack of organic strawberries. I've been loving fruit, you guys, clearly. It's a great way, it's a great sweet treat. It's a great way to get your fruit in for the day. So between the blueberries, the grapes, and the strawberries, I am set. And I also bought bananas, mainly to get these really ripe and freeze them for my smoothies, but we can have these as snacks as well. They were out of the organic lemons at Trader Joe's, so I just grabbed regular lemons for my water. I have a big bag of the teeny tiny, let's see, there we go, the teeny tiny avocados. I just needed some more avocados. They have these really good organic sweet onions. So I decided to get these because I thought that that would be good in recipes. I like the sweeter onions for the most part in most recipes. Grabbed another pack of the organic tri-color of the bell peppers, and then also a 2-pack of green pepper. I need a lot of peppers this week for recipes. An organic tomato for a recipe, a red onion for a recipe, and then I found these mixed medley organic cherry tomatoes. I needed cherry tomatoes for 2 separate recipes, and this is a big container. It was like $3, so I grabbed that. Of course, basil for recipes and for salads. So that is everything, my friends, for the first portion of this massive grocery haul. I'll put all this away, and I'll be back in a flash with the second equally as large grocery haul. Here's the last of the grocery haul. Maybe it's not as big as the first part, but Whew, I'm exhausted. This was a lot of shopping, but it's my usual Costco trip, which really just adds to it. So I'm gonna show you what I picked up non-food for the second part, and then we'll get into what I grabbed for groceries. Some Colgate Total mouthwash, just because we had a great coupon for this and we always like to stock up. And then I grabbed some washing machine cleaner. This stuff works so good, and it's about half the price of Tide. It is awesome. Whenever I do a lot of laundry with a lot of dog hair, I like to run a cycle and run this through, and my washing machine comes out sparkling, so highly recommend. And then I grabbed some of the scrubbing bubbles toilet gel. I find that if I use this in my toilet, it prevents me from having to scrub it every week. I just put a little dollop in the toilet bowl, and it works really well. Grabbed an orange buttercream wax melt. This is one of my very favorite ones, and it popped up on the, would you like to add this to your Walmart order? So of course it got me, and I said yes, so I grabbed that. And then we've been looking for alcohol, and the only thing we can find are these prep pads. The dogs, like I mentioned, have had a few ticks, and whenever we remove the tick, we like to clean the area really well with the alcohol, and we haven't been able to find it. So I grabbed these just so that we had these on hand. They're little individual wrapped pads, so that's even better. And then I grabbed the Lemme Shine dishwasher cleaner. This stuff, again, works so good. It's a little pricey, but your dishwasher, no lie, comes out sparkling clean. And as you know, we just got new appliances, so I wanted to do a wash through of my dishwasher, so I picked that up. My husband asked specifically for this scent, Cashmere Woods of the Glade air freshener for his bathroom, so I grabbed that. And then my new range came with a little trial version of this glass cooktop cleaner. This stuff works fantastic. So now that little trial version's almost gone, I grabbed a full size one. And then of course Windex, just for cleaning all the mirrors in the windows. And last but not least, some Gang Flings. These were on coupon for $2.99, couldn't pass it up, so I grabbed it. So that's everything non-food related. I grabbed 2 dozen of the Happy Eggs. These are my favorite eggs, you guys know. I love these so much, and I'm actually making an egg-based breakfast, so I needed quite a few eggs this week, of course. Between this and the Good Culture, it's just a guarantee in every grocery haul. So I have 2 strawberry, 4 vanilla of the Cleo bars. I didn't buy as many because I still have a few left from the last time I did a Walmart pickup, which I think was a couple of weeks ago. And then I needed some egg, liquid eggs, whole eggs. What are they called? Well, you know, these things. What's the name brand? I cannot think of it off the top of my head. But anyways, I needed these egg beaters for a recipe. So I picked up the Simple Truth Organic. And then I really like this creamer. So I will give you guys a report back on that coconut creamer. Actually, let me go show it to you. If you don't remember I was excited to find this at Walmart, and I thought, oh, this is gonna be my new staple because it doesn't have natural flavors. I don't like it. It doesn't have very good flavor at all, so it will not be a new staple. So I guess I'm going back to natural flavors. So I did decide to go ahead and grab the Organic Valley Sweet Cream. I know that I really like this one, and all of the ingredients are organic, so I figure the lesser of two evils. And I was so excited to go back to my Forager cashew milk. This is my all-time favorite milk ever. And I'm almost out of my Great Value almond milk. And this, I love this one. It's so delicious. And then I restocked my yogurts because I'm completely out. I've eaten them all. So I have a Siggy's 4% full fat vanilla. I actually got 3 of those and 3 of the mixed berry. A pound of 99% simply raised ground turkey. This is the best, closest thing to a good grass-fed organic. I know it's not, but the closest thing I can find in my area. Big block of mozzarella cheese. This is for a recipe. You guys, wait till you hear my meal plan and wait till next Monday's meal prep. It's gonna be so good. So I need a mozzarella. I really wanted pastrami, or my husband did for his lunches, but they didn't have any. I'm like, how do you not have pastrami? So I thought next best thing, this is a turkey seasoned with pastrami seasoning. So hopefully he doesn't notice and likes it just as much. So I grabbed that for his lunch. And then Swiss cheese, this is for him. He wanted Swiss on his sandwiches. He does put 2 pieces per sandwich. So we go through quite a bit of cheese during the week. Tzatziki, this is for a recipe. Not the best ingredients. This is better than the other brands. And I just didn't wanna have to make it myself. I know that you can, but I actually need this for a recipe this week. Whole milk ricotta, again, for a dinner recipe. I really like this brand, and the whole milk is so good. It's worth the extra points and calories. Cheese tortellini, this is for meal prep. Yes, my friends, I'm making a tortellini dish. Cannot wait. And then a bag of frozen corn for a dinner recipe. So that's it. Finally, we are through the massive haul. Now let's take a quick look at what I'm doing for my meal plan and meal prep. So here is this week's menu and what I'm going to be doing on for meal prep. You guys will be seeing meal prep on Monday, so stay tuned for that. So today's Saturday. Oh, this is the week of July 18th through the 24th. So today's Saturday, we are going out for dinner. We always support a local business on Saturday. Tomorrow, I'm making taco mac and cheese cups. I'm so excited about these. Hello, macaroni and cheese and tacos. Yes, please. You will be seeing this video this recipe in next Wednesday's What I Eat in a Day video. So stay tuned for that. You're not going to want to miss it. Monday is going to be Greek feta burgers. That's what I picked up the tzatziki for. Tuesday, I'm going to do a slow cooker turkey pesto lasagna. So kind of the best of both worlds, lasagna and pesto, all in the slow cooker. Tuesday's a busy day for me. I usually clean my house and get caught up on emails and things. So it's nice to have a slow cooker meal just on those nights that are just really, really busy. Wednesday is a leftover night. Thursday, we're going to be making Dorito taco salad. So we're going to be using that romaine lettuce I bought and basically making a taco salad using Doritos. It is a little bit higher in points, but it's going to be kind of an indulgent salad. So we're excited for that. And then lastly, on Friday, we'll do leftovers simply because chances are we'll have quite a bit left over from earlier in the week. So for meal prep, so these are the recipes that you'll be seeing on Monday. So you definitely don't want to miss Monday's video. So stay tuned. I'm going to be making a country breakfast casserole. This is going to be so hearty, delicious, clean eating. I can't wait for that. Lunch, I'm doing a tortellini and mozzarella salad. That's what I bought the mozzarella cheese for, the tortellini. We're gonna pair this with some protein. It's going to be so good and refreshing on a hot day. And then my friends, we're making cinnamon sugar messy bread. So similar to monkey bread, but we're gonna do it clean eating style and WW friendly. So stay tuned for that. So make sure you don't miss Monday's video. So that is my meal plan and my meal prep for the week. Thank you for joining me on another weekly grocery haul. My goodness gracious, did I do some shopping. We are stocked up and good to go, especially with Costco for quite a while. I'm so bummed out about the mayonnaise, but I guess I'll just have to pay a little bit more over on the Thrive Market to pick up that same mayonnaise once I run out. I'm gonna ration and I'm gonna hoard what I have left though for sure. So I hope you enjoyed this week's grocery haul. If you did and you're new, I'd love it if you'd take a moment, hit that little subscribe button and the bell next to it so you're notified when new videos are uploaded. I do a grocery haul every Saturday, so you don't wanna miss a single one. If you love today's video, give this one a big thumbs up. And of course, if you know the answers to some of the burning questions in today's video, please leave those down in the comments for me. Check out the description box below for my website, discount codes and links to my favorite things, including the Thrive Market, as well as the link to head over and join my Facebook group. We'd love to have you join us over there. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekend, and I'll see you all in tomorrow's video. Bye, guys. Bye, darling, I love you, 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 I love you.